Elisha.
God knows everything about the enemy.
He says, I have come
that they may have life
and life in abundance.
Yet we shun away from that life.
Who bewitched us?
We have everything, saints, that we need.
All the tools.
The government have got everything that they need. But look at how the cities are collapsing. Because of corruption. But they have all the tools to make sure that they can make this South Africa to be beautiful. We're failing with the tools that the Lord has granted us. We have become the same as the other people who are now praying for blessings, praying for cars and for this and for that, and we have forgotten to intercede for the brethren in the body of Christ. Because we must understand that if the foot is broken, if the arm is broken, if the ear has been cut off, that body does not function very well. So the other parts must make sure that they help the broken part to repair it and bring it back to life. But not to scorn it and gossip about it. Your first love. Jesus says, I have come to give you life.
Amen.
Take it.
Amen.
Saints, Jesus is coming. It is very serious. Check your time. We cannot live as we want. Yet we sing, we are saving the
mighty God.
These things I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. John 16:33. He says, in the world ye shall have tribulation. But be of good cheer. I have come, I have overcome the world. Behold what manner of love the Father had bestowed upon us. That we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not. That's what the word is saying. The word, the word of God, that's what the word of God is saying. The world does not know us. But yet we want to fit in into the world. We fall intentionally. Oh Lord. Beloved, now are we the sons of God.
Yes, sir.
And it do not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him. For we shall see him as he is. And every man that had his hope in him.
Purifieth
himself. Even as he is pure. That is 1 John chapter
3.
Humble yourselves therefore under the mighty hand of God. That he may exalt you in due time. Casting all your care upon him. For he careth for you. 1 Peter chapter 5. Romans chapter 12. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
2
Peter chapter 1, from verse 3. According as his divine power had given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness, through the knowledge of him that had called us to glory and virtue, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these you might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have come.
Get clean.
That they might have life and more in abundance. As we stand on our feet, say, behold, what manner of love. The fact that God speaks like this to us today, he's giving us another chance to come back to him. When we go back to the very same scripture, let me quickly go to it. In verse 5, Revelation chapter 2. In verse 5, it says, remember therefore from whence thou art fallen. That is grace. That statement on its own is grace. Remember where you have fallen and repent. Bring back your attention to me. Bring back your focus to me. And do the first works. Or else I will come unto thee quickly and will remove thy candlestick out of his place, except thou repent. Hallelujah, saints.
Amen.
As we speak like this today, maybe somebody says, this is not talking to me. Because I know that I have been doing good. But let me tell you one thing. The word of God does not come down and return back to him void. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God would not speak like this if he did not see a need to speak like this. The fact that God speaks this
way,
it is because he looks at our hearts. You are looking at my suit. You think this pastor is holy and righteous. God looks at my because you are a preacher. God is not speaking to you. I have come to tell you that God is speaking to you. As a preaching machine as you can be, God is speaking to you. God is speaking to all of us. Repent before I remove you. Repent before your time is over. Repent before the grace is ended. Repent. Go back to where you were before. When I first met you, there was fire of love. There was intimacy. What happened to the intimacy? What happened to you spending time with me? Surprise the Lord. The Bible says, the Lord is standing outside and he's knocking. How did we chunk him outside of his church? Glory to Jesus. He says, repent. Remember where you come from. Remember your works. Remember how you used to wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning because you just had a dream and you are praying. Remember when you would open your Bible right inside the text sheet. Remember when you used to run around with talents and you were preaching this gospel. When you used to preach and testify to your neighbors and friends, remember, just remember. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah.
Oh, Lord. When we sang bow down and worship him, we are not just singing in the church.
We have to repent.
Look at our soul.
because the time is not more. We have to repent. The time is no more. We do not have time anymore. You used to testify. You used to testify. What happened to the testimony? You used to find a person on the road and you tell them about Christ. What happened to the testimony? What happened to the testimony? On your desk at school, you will testify to your fellow classmates. What happened to your testimony? What happened? Where is the first love? Today you are not in good terms with your neighbor. Where is the first love? Why don't you go and mend the relationship? What Jesus are you representing? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just because he doesn't want me, I don't know. No man. Go back and mend the relations. Because you are the Son of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You forgive even though somebody did not apologize. That's who you are. That is your talent. You love even though you are not loved. They hate you for nothing. But remain loving. Because it is your character. It is who you are. You cannot have the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. And do something else. You cannot have the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. You cannot confess that you've got the Holy Spirit, but being led by the evil spirits. What cannot happen, saints? The very same spoken word that we have. Let us use it to purify ourselves. You do not know the time when you will depart from this world. So make sure that you do whatever that God has purposed you to do in this world when you are still alive. If you say you have heard the word,
how will you open it?
Not by any faces. If you say you have heard the word, and you have a prayerful heart, and you really want to change today, you don't want to get used to Jesus, but you want him to amaze you every time. Every time you look at him, he is holier than before. He is holier and holier than before. If you say, I am here today, then the message came down from the people. And today it has changed my heart. And I want to change the way I do things. Raise your hands. Let us pray together. I am one of those who say, Lord, I have heard you today that you are praying about the best love, that I have moved away from Jesus, that I have moved away from you, but yet I'm calling myself a Christian. But yet I'm calling myself your son. Lord, here we are. We humble ourselves before you. We have raised our hands.
not because we are used to raising them, but Lord, we bring ourselves to you. Do as you will with our lives. Lord, we are tired that we have all the tools you have provided, but yet we live according to our will. We have learned the first love. We hear you crying and complaining, not because you want to complain, O Lord, but because you love us and you've got grace for us. And we accept the praise, O Lord. Help us, O Jesus. Help us, O Lord. We want to see the paradise. We want to come to the paradise as well. We want to come to the paradise as well. When you come, Lord, we pray that you find faith. When you come, O Lord, we pray that you find your wife alive and kicking. We pray, O Lord Jesus, that not even one member of the body will be lost when you come. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, this morning for your word. That comes directly from you. Rebuking us, Lord. In order to strengthen us. So that we can focus on you. And give our attention to you, Lord Jesus. We should not sleep, oh Lord. While we need to pray. Not to sleep in your presence. Not to sleep in your vicinity. But to stay focused. But to keep our attention to you. And know that we should trust upon you. That when the enemy rises high like the floods, that we know you will do better. Surely you have already done it, Lord. Because he's fighting and losing battles. And we thank you, Jesus, for your love and care. You say we must not worry about tomorrow. We must cast all our burdens unto you. For you care for us. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, so.